Oh, no.
What are you doing?
Oh, hey, Hetty, this is fun.
Oh, this is not fun. This horrible man has destroyed the sanctity of our rooms.
Oh, it's like we're roommates.
You got this. Crap.
Are you mad? You made it even bigger. No, 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 don't walk away.
Hey, who's your favorite boy ghost? I'd say Thor, but he really scares me, but I kind of like that.
You know what? No. No, 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 no,
well, then the bear raised his arms to attack me, but the shrooms were kicking in, and I thought he just wanted a hug. You know how everyone talks about bear hugs? They're not talking about hugs from actual bears.
Can you please stop talking? I'm trying to sleep.
Oh, yeah, no, totally. Yeah, no, I'm so tired, too. Why do we sleep?
I don't know.
When I was at Woodstock, I didn't sleep at all because I didn't want to miss anything, especially the Grateful Dead. I was a huge Deadhead, which was ironic because I wasn't even dead at the time.
I don't care.
But it was strange not to be able to see you all. It has been my constant dream for the last century, but then when it actually happened, I missed you guys.
Aw, really? You missed us?
No, I'm not repeating it. Flower, I'm sure I'll regret this, but are you all right?
Well, I wanted to watch the basketball game with Pete, but he only wants to watch with stupid boys. I love basketball. Is that surprising?
A little. But I do know how much you enjoy being disheveled and sweaty, so that's not a far cry.
I played in high school. One game I had 20 points in the first half, but then I didn't score any after that because I got super high at halftime with our point guard. I mean, we got some really good stuff, man. Wait, what were we talking about?
Basketball, but then it veered wildly off course.
Right. Yeah, I thought that after the sexual revolution...
Mm-hmm, here we go.
...that this stuff would get better, that women would really be equal. But now it's 50 years later, and Pete isn't treating me like an equal at all.
Flower, I spent far too long forgiving the sins of men in my lifetime. I see no reason why we need to put up with it in the afterlife. Do not just sit there and take being disrespected by a man. Do something about it. Talk to Peter.
Damn, Eddie, are you a feminist now?
Well, as long as it doesn't mean supporting women handling money or riding bicycles. Yeah, I think I am a feminist. No one calls my descendant a jerkwad, which from context I take to be some sort of derision.
We trusted you, man, and you stole our money.
That's not what happened. Okay, let's just go.
Come on. You shut up. You shut up right now.
Oh, hey, Hetty. You yelling at the washing machine? That's cool.
This vile contraption will not let me nap.
You know, there is an upside to a broken washing machine.
What could possibly be good about this deafening monstrosity?
Sit on it.
Sit on it?
Yes.
Why would I ever do something like that?
Just trust me.
Fine, I will indulge you, if for no other reason than to end this conversation. Oh, my.
I'll leave you two alone.
Well, if you're referring to my relaxed demeanor, it may have something to do with a magical encounter I had recently with the washing machine.
What happened with the washing machine?
No one knows. Peter, it's simply one of the magical mysteries of the universe.
Wait. Hetty, do you really not know what was happening on the washing machine?
Not a clue.
It was making you aroused.
Oh, yes.
Sexually.
What?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I will certainly not be doing that again. I succumbed to my demons, and I sat on the washing machine again.
Look, being ashamed of female pleasure was just some BS thing that men thought up to control women. There is nothing wrong with feeling good, Hetty. And you don't need a man's permission.
Heavens to Betsy! Oh, what a time to be alive. I mean, you know what I mean. Goodbye, old friend. I will always remember your spin cycle.
You know, you don't need a washing machine to achieve the feeling.
You don't?
There are so many other things you can do. Here, walk with me.
Dear Lord. Oh, I would never.